This maybe looks like a sad page, but there is a nice technique of adding paint to it, and so I invite you to stay tuned and watch it with me. It's Asia Marquet here, Lemon Creation. Okay, my lovely people, let's go on with the process. I'm working in my old book. I decided to make a tiny bit of layers, which at the end are not that visible. They are still there, but not that visible. And I'm doing it by adding a masking tape to the page. But the reason for me to add a masking tape is very important in that case. It just will hold the book together because it's really old, and the more pages I add, the more bulky it gets and the more easily it cracks. So I'm keeping that way the book in one place, and I'm also preventing from the paint seepage on the other pages. But as you will see, now I'll add a little bit of string to the page, just very randomly. It was not meant to be a flower. This is just a kind of a blob of the string I got, and I'm keeping it in place more or less with the washi tape, masking tape, and then I'm gonna add a little bit of white gesso from Finnabair. And then again, that will make the thread stick to the page, and also once again it will prevent the seepage of the paint through the pages and will keep the whole process or the whole page more or less together, well, more than less. And I also, without drying it, I also added a little bit of crackles accents, because, well, it's a sad page, as I mentioned already. It's been a hard time for me lately. I don't know if it's you know, the winter, which is long, or the coronavirus, or whatever that is. I kind of got a lot of sadness in me, and I think that page is just about me releasing this sadness. This page is also about paint application, and believe me, when I was applying two colors, and when I was applying the first color, I didn't realize that I actually ran out of memory, so it didn't record. So I applied the second one, and I'm showing you how I did it. I have Lindy's gang sprays, but Lindy is selling also dabbers. And so, you know, you can just unscrew the sprayer and just put the dabber on, and that's what I'm doing. It's like, you know, this ink dabber from Tim Holtz, for example, you know. And just to be also, you know, to give you an idea on how can you do it without buying actual dabber, you can use a sponge. And with a sponge, you can dab it kind of on the page with the ink, with the actual paint. And as you can see, I am inclining it a little bit right now, and I'm kind of drawing the lines on it. So you can use it either, you know, placing it really well on the page, and then you're gonna get this kind of thick lines, or you can just incline it a little and just add it and kind of draw lines which are much thinner. And I don't know why I don't use this technique very often, or more often. I don't know, maybe it's just for me too much troubles to change the dabbers. I also don't have that many of them, so, you know, I don't want to waste them all. But I find that it's very nice sometimes, you know, when you don't want to repeat the same process all over again, use the same you know, techniques on adding paints, this is the way to go. So if you don't have a Lindy's gang dabber, or, you know, other sprays with dabbers, you can actually use a little bit of sponge, and you can go ahead and do it like that. And now I'm stamping, of course. It seems like my voiceover doesn't go the same, you know, at the same time as my actual film. But I was stamping with IndigoBlu stamps, also with my stamps. You're gonna find the links to all the products in the description box below. I need to start actually putting the names of the products in the description box below. Lately I haven't done that, but I will. And so my stamps also you can buy in my shop. I hope you're gonna have a look there. And this is also a washi tape I made. For now I'm adding it to, I think, almost every single parcel I'm sending away as a freebie. But I was thinking maybe one day I'll put it in a shop actually as an article to buy. but you know, I'm not sure, so I'm doing freebies now, like that. And so it's normally a sticky material. How do you call it? I don't know. It's a sticker. Oi, it's a sticker. But I use a little bit of glue because my page is already uneven with all the gesso and the crackle paste and everything like that. And I'm making small borders to add a little bit of accent of white. Very hard to work with the borders because, of course, the page is not smooth. And now to dim a little bit these strong colors, I'm adding a heavy, super heavy gesso. I don't use Finnabair gesso for that, I find it it's not good enough. And I'm doing a dry brush technique, so I'm using my old brush and adding a little bit of gesso like that. And the colors will become a little bit more soft. And this is my acrylic black paint to go from Le Franc Bourgeois, I think. I use this one, it's a paint for children, but it's a good acrylic, and because I use a lot of white and black very often, I'm just using this one. And this is a very nice technique also. Technique I learned from Didicatron. If you apply gesso on your page and then you make a splatter with black paint, with black acrylic paint, and you dry it, but not fully, you know, you have these big, kind of big blobs of paint on your page, and you quickly go over it and dry it, and then you take a baby wipe or some kind of damp cloth and remove the paint, what's gonna stay on the page, it's actually a circle, it's the border of the splatter. And you have to be careful because in this case I use Lindy's, so they are not water resistant. So I have to be careful when I do that. I have to really dab in the precise place, otherwise I'm gonna smudge the paint from Lindy's. But look at that. This is what's happening. I don't know if you can see. I'm trying to show you with my finger. They are just, you know, these funny circular borders. And I have to do something like that. With something bigger, you know, much visible, because I really love this technique and I am forgetting so many techniques. It's actually breaking me, you know, sometimes I'm thinking, oh, I know this one and I know this one and I don't use it. That's the thing also, you know, you have to just go with the flow and just create what you feel like. And now this is gonna be my focal point, but I wanted to add a little bit of base to it to make it a little bit more dimensional. I didn't do the shadow because shadow would have to be black, but I added a little bit of cardstock paper also like that. It's more sturdy. The photo will not bend because my surface underneath is uneven. So this is also a good idea, you know, if your surface is uneven, it's better, even if you use 3D foam to glue it to the page, it's better actually to put it on the piece of paper which is quite quite thick. And in this case I left the borders so like that I have a little 3D effect. I'm going to use, of course, my super messy words. I absolutely love them and I use them, I think, for almost every project. And this sentiment just goes perfectly with this man and with this sad, sad page. And this is it, guys. I hope you like it. I'm really sorry once again that not all the paint application was there, but I hope you understood it. If not, let me know in the comments. I'll be happy to answer. As always, please subscribe, share and like. And I hope I'll see you in the next more happy video. Bye bye.